your brake calipers. So I'll be using a G2 caliper paint kit, and I'll be doing this with the calipers off the car. Okay, before we start painting the calipers, you have to make sure it's clean. Paint sticks to a surface at its best when the surface is as clean as possible. So we're going to use a wire brush and either use brake cleaner or an engine degreaser. And just use a wire brush, small or big, doesn't matter. Just use a wire brush to scrape up all the contaminants off of this. When you're cleaning the calipers, make sure you don't clean the boots, because those get damaged very easily. You don't want to rip. It's not like you're painting the boots anyways. So you just leave it alone or mask it off. Scrub everything you see besides the boot. Just protect it. Since this tutorial is for painting it off the car, you want to remove your calipers off the car first. First things first, you're going to jack up the car, put on jack stands, and remove the wheels. You can remove the boot to make everything easier. You can use a steel brush on your rotary tool if you need to get into the small crevices on your brake caliper parts.
And this is the G2 caliper paint kit.
Okay, so it comes with non-chlorinated brake cleaner, which most of it is nowadays. The activator small bottle. It activates the epoxy. And then you have the actual paint. Stirring stick. Paintbrush. Instructions. Now spray down every single part with the brake cleaner they give you.
Before we start painting it, we're going to need to suspend every single piece into the air. It is highly recommended, because if you do this on the ground or on the table, it's going to be very hard to paint the back of the calipers, and it's going to ruin the paint if you try to put it on the table.
So this hole right here is the caliper mounting bracket hole, and I highly recommend that you mount it here, because it actually sits behind the rotors, and you will never see it from the outside of the car. And make sure you cut off the loose ends, because it might touch the paint.
After you cut the rope, try burning the tips so that little frays of it do not fall on the paint. Here's all my parts hanging up. Looks pretty creepy, but you have to do this. Here's the other half of them. Creepy as always.
Okay, so the moment you all been waiting for, we're gonna start mixing the paint with the epoxy reactor. Open this up. Reactor. Get every drop in there. Alright, now take the supplied stirring stick, which is a popsicle stick, honestly, and stir it nicely. Do not knock this can over. It will be the saddest day of your life, honestly. So after you stirred it nicely, you're gonna wait 5 minutes. And when it's 5 minutes again, then you're gonna stir again, and then we can start painting. And just a heads up, once you stir the reactor into the paint, you have about 4 to 6 hours to finish the job, which is insanely plenty of time. Okay, so the instruction says it's recommended that you paint in the temperatures between 56 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit and with low to no humidity. So just try your best. And when you're painting, the chemical is very volatile, so you should wear a mask just in case. Okay, so it reached 5 minutes for the reactor to do its thing, and now we're gonna mix it one last time.
Just for safety measures, I'm going to use the brake cleaner lightly. Just I recommend you mask off the bleeder screw for each of your calipers. Make sure your hands are clean when you're painting, because you will be touching certain spots in the caliper that are safe to touch with no paint, just in case.
So you're going to cover the entire caliper with a thin coat.
This is the first light coat. It looks so beautiful already. And just make sure it's light coat because it will drip if you do too much on the paintbrush. And at the very end, I think you should just take the paintbrush and just slide it underneath just in case those drips. You're gonna wait 15 minutes to apply the second coat. Okay, I'm about to start the second coat. It's definitely over 15 minutes already, but it's okay. And you'll notice that I did not paint the part where I touched because I am going to paint that the very last thing. Remember I said it goes behind the rotor, so you'll never see it. So I'm just gonna do a very light coat at the very end just to finish it up. You don't have to paint the inside where the brake pads will be, but everything on the outside is good. Inspect all the parts, and if you see any drip marks, use the brush, dry, and just brush it off. Because if you don't brush off now, the drip marks will stay there forever. I'm all done now with two coats, and you should not touch it within 24 hours. And it takes about 2 to 3 days for it to fully cure. Just wait until it fully cures and then install it back in your car.